freedom to worship any way you want to. Raise your hands, dance, shout, and join in.
On this next one, I want everybody to know God is not dead. Amen. He's a living God today. No matter what problems you're going through, no matter what sickness you have, He can take it all away. He took it all away on that cross over 2,000 years ago.
Come on.
I'm telling you, no matter what you got, whether work you're signing, whether someone's singing, if you need something, come up here. Everyone of us will pray with you.
Amen.
I mean, everybody in here is praying somebody, ain't they?
Come on.
So bring this song, no matter what's going on in your life, you can seek Him.
Come on.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
what those songs mean to me.
Come on. Come on.
Especially starting with Now Behold the Lamb on this verse that I signed. About no matter how far I've gone.
Come on. My God.
How much I know when I broke his heart.
Amen.
How much he's actually been there with me.
My God.
Come on now.
Jesus.
God has worked with so many things in my life. Without him, I wouldn't be here tonight.
Come on.
Without him, I wouldn't have been here 10 years ago. When I was 6 years old, me and my mom went through a really rough patch. She got a divorce with my dad, and he decided he didn't want to pay it. He threw the child support. He didn't want to pay anything. He didn't want to have anything to do with me.
Jesus.
My mom had to decide whether or not she wanted to pay the bill to keep the lights on and put food at our table. I had to decide whether or not I was going to take a shower this week or next week because we didn't have the money to be able to pay a water bill to be able to take showers every day. I had to go to school and listen to high school kids tell me that I was better off that I would run away or kill myself because my mom couldn't afford to take care of me.
Bless him, Lord.
And you know, I believed him. I was a six-year-old kid and I believed him. I carried that kind of depression around for a long time. And it hit the peak when I was with my dad one summer because he decided that he wanted me to come up. I thought I was going to be able to get away from that feeling because I wasn't having to put it on my mom for an entire summer that she had to take care of me. I thought I was going to get away from the pain. I thought I was going to get away from it all, but I didn't know that my dad was a severe alcoholic.
Come on.
I didn't know my dad was going to take me into a room one night, beat me, and then look at me and say it was my fault that him and my mom got a divorce. It wasn't until that night that I decided I was going to go down to the basement and end it off. It was that night that I decided I was going to write everybody a note saying they didn't have to deal with me anymore, that I wouldn't be a burden on them anymore.
Come on.
It was that night that I laid on the floor and I cried out to God asking if there was a reason for me to show me something, to give me a reason to walk back up the stairs, to give me a reason to want to get up the next day.
Bless him, Lord.
It was that night that whenever I went to finish that act, that when I knocked the chair over, the rope broke.
Amen.
I listened to a soft, still voice coming, even in my ear, even in my heart, and say, even when you're at the end of that rope, I'm always hanging on to the other side.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Yes, sir.
Praise
the Lord.
It wasn't until that night that I looked around and I said, instead of blaming God, why was I going through all this? Instead of blaming God, why was I in this situation? Then I looked at him and I said, thank you for bringing me through it.
Yes.
It was that moment that I realized that I could look back at it and say, if it wasn't for what I went through then, what he brought me through then, I wouldn't be where I am now.
Come on, amen. Come on.
I still fight with depression every day in my life, but I know that there's a reason to go through it because I know that my God has a purpose for me today.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because I know that I can go to an altar. I know that I can sit down and I can cry out to God, and there's not a moment that I'm not listening. There's a time every day, every second, God sitting right beside you just saying, will you just take my hand through this instead of trying to fight it on your own?
Amen.
And it's something so many people don't understand because they look at it and they say, why did I have to come to this situation?
Come on.
And say, thank God for bringing me to this situation so I can bring this relationship closer to you.
Yes. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
I think about that night all the time. And I think about how much would be different the first time I told my mom about it. I feel guilty because of the pain in her eyes. Because I thought that the people around me didn't care. I thought that there wasn't a point in going on. But it wasn't until I decided that I was going to let God mold my life.
Amen.
That I was going to give it to Him and not to myself. That I realized on how far and fulfilling my life could go.
Good Lord.
I can't thank Him enough for breaking that rope. I can't thank Him enough for all the other chains He's broke since He did.
Yes.
I can't thank Him enough for being a friend. I can't thank Him enough for what He did on Calvary.
Amen.
To know that the man took a beating so bad that he didn't even look like a man hanging on the cross. But He did it for me, and He did it for everybody else in this room. It wasn't just a one person thing. He was for anybody.
Amen.
It doesn't matter who you are, what you've done, how far you've come.
Come on now. Bless and good Lord.
Because God doesn't call the equipped. He quits the call. No matter your situation, no matter your story can touch somebody else. You might be fighting the same battles as the person sitting across from you in this room. But you never know until you let God use that. I pray that if you're fighting with something tonight, if you're struggling so bad you think you can't keep going on, God, that you take His hand and you walk up to an altar. And you lay it down because there's nothing going to be better than it. There's not a medicine you can take. There's not enough money in the world that you can get that can pay for it.
Come on.
With this relationship, there's nothing that can describe it on what it can do. There's nothing to describe it on what it can make you feel.
Amen.
If you're fighting with something tonight, don't leave with it.
That's right.
Don't leave with it. Don't let those chains drag.
Amen.
Give it to the King of Kings.
Yeah.
Forever shall knock, let the door be opened.
Yeah.
Whatever you seek, thou shall find.
Thank you, Lord.
It is not in the heart of man.
That's
right. It's in the man that died on the Calvary.
Yes.
Amen.
I've had the privilege of working with a lot of teenage kids. And at one point, I had eight of them that I was working with at one time. And seven of them had tried to commit suicide. I don't know if you all realize the pressures that's put on people these days.
Amen.
So uplift these young people. They step out and do God's work.
Amen.
But I guess my sister was going to sing some numbers.
If I can. You can't hear me, I'll get quiet. Okay. We're going to do this one because this is what my brother does. We have to give it up and let Jesus take over.
Amen.
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 You got the word, I'll see it on you, right?
But don't tell you.
You know, it's funny that she said that. Oh, I feel the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
It's funny that she says that, brother, I can see that God's given you something.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Them boys begin to sing a song that we do back home at my church. Amen. And all them little kids, they get up there and they do their dance. Amen. They give their time for the Lord. Amen. But that song's got a lot of meaning that comes to me. Amen. It begins to talk about rivers of living water. Amen. Do you understand the concept behind the song tonight? Amen. Do you realize, amen, to have a river, amen, the water's got to flow. Can I get an amen in here tonight? Amen, I'm here to tell you, if you stay on God's anointing, if you stay on God's call that's on your life, amen, I'm here to tell you that that river of living water that was placed inside of you, amen, that it'll become a boil of water. Amen, it won't flow, hallelujah. Amen, the only reason why, hallelujah, that we have lakes, Brother J-Bob, is because we built dams up. But I wish somebody in here would begin to tear down the walls. Hallelujah. Somebody would begin to tear down the very things that's damming you up tonight. Hallelujah. Amen. If you begin to get around water that can't flow, amen, there's a smell that comes. Hallelujah. It's got a stench to it. Amen. That stench is called sin. Is that all right? Amen. Amen. As long as I got breath in my body, hallelujah, I will always preach about sin. Amen. But I'm here to tell you, if you don't tear down the dam tonight, amen, that water will not flow again. Amen, honey. We wonder. People say, oh, I want to be like you and your wife. Amen. I wish I, amen, could put a video on Facebook. Amen. And have all these people like it and watch it and see all these people blessed by the things. I'm here to tell you there's nothing special about me and my wife. Amen. When I was 15 years old, I got this girl pregnant. Hallelujah. I'm here to tell you, I don't care how much you beat the Word of God into these children's head. There'll come a time that they'll have to choose this day whom they will serve. Amen. And I chose the wrong way. Hallelujah. I believe that God had this woman destined for me. Amen. But we took things in our own hands. Amen. We begin to build up a dam, Brother J-Bob. We begin to let what God had placed in our lives from a young age. Amen. That anointing, that call that's on your life. Amen. That anointing began to get stagnated. Amen. Because I'm here to tell you, you know why the Grand Canyon is so wide and it's so deep? Because I'm here to tell you that water can cut things. Amen. That no wind, that no movement can do. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. I like taking my boys down to the river. Amen. Amen. And we begin to pick up some stones. Amen. There's another man in the Bible. Amen. When he went down to the river, the Bible didn't say that he picked up some jagged stones. It didn't say that he picked up these rough things. It said he picked up five smooth stones. And I'm here to tell you the reason why that these things have become smooth is because the living water of God has molded them into what God had wanted them to be. And I don't know about you. Amen. But when I get my boys down there by the water, amen, Trevor, he's still learning how to pick a good smooth stone. Amen. He'll try to get him a rock. Amen. And he'll try to skip it across the water like me and his brothers do. Amen. But sometimes all he gets to make is one big splash and that's it. Where are you going, brother? I'm here to tell you this walk that God called you to do wasn't for that one Sunday night. It wasn't for that one splash. It wasn't meant to be. Amen. That one certain time in your life. Amen. God wants you to stay upon the water. Amen. And reach out a little deeper. Hallelujah. Amen. But I want you to know tonight. Amen. If you feel like you're stuck, Brother J. Bob, I know a man. I know a man who can. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And if you got a damn tonight, I don't know what she's going to preach. I didn't come to preach, but I didn't come to me. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Who came expecting you?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Them boys, hallelujah, they put on a show unto the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. They didn't get up here and look all prideful. Yeah. They didn't look all boastful.
Come on.
Amen.
Come on.
Hallelujah. Come on. But they humbled themselves before their God. And they began to seek His face. And what did we do?
Come on.
Yeah, come on.
Come on.
Come on, somebody.
Oh,
yeah. Amen.
Oh,
that same spirit that rose Lazarus from the dead. That same spirit, hallelujah. Hallelujah is the same spirit that is alive and well today in here, in me, and in you. And I'm here to tell you, amen, if you can move some things out of your life, you can feel that burning like Jeremiah said. He said it's like a fire shook in my home. Hallelujah. That I feel on you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. I don't preach denomination. Amen. But I tend to lean a lot towards the Pentecostal faith. Amen. Because I have some people. Amen. That I can walk arm in arm with.
Amen.
I don't care who thinks I'm crazy.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Josh Bowman sings a song called I Believe.
Amen.
Amen. And that song said that I believe in true blood bought salvation.
Yeah. Yeah.
Living right, sanctification.
Yeah.
Amen. Some of them may laugh at me.
Yeah, come on.
Amen. Some of them may laugh at you. Amen. In today's world, living for God ain't cool. Amen.
Come on.
Right.
Well, can I get real for just a moment?
Come on.
Serving God, little brother, ain't cool anymore.
Come on.
Amen. When you're walking around and your phone rings, amen, my son, hallelujah. Amen, I heard his phone ring the other day. Amen, and that ringtone didn't sound like what I taught him to listen to. Right?
Come on.
Amen. Come on now. Amen. What are we letting in our homes?
Come on.
Hallelujah. What are we placing in between the bricks to hold them together? Amen. That mortar. Amen. Comes from the Word of God. That mortar comes from praying and fasting. Hallelujah. Amen. But I'm here to tell you, if we don't cut the sin out of our homes, we're going to have a cursed generation coming up underneath. I've seen a lot of mamas and daddies that say I can't handle my child.
Well,
amen. I'm here to tell you the Bible still says beat them, they shall not die.
Oh, yeah.
Come on. Amen. That's the end of fall, word of God.
Amen.
Okay.
It's the word.
When I do wrong, the Lord whoops me.
Yes.
Nobody likes the chastisement. Come on now. Amen. But I can tell you right now, my son, amen, he might have a mind disability.
Come on.
He might not be as fast as every 7-year-old out there. Amen, but even though when he does wrong, Daddy still has to get on to him.
Right.
Amen, and I feel something on the inside of me that makes me want to mourn when I see him hurt. Amen, but that child still knows what love means.
Yeah.
Amen, after I chastise him a little bit, he'll lay his head on Daddy's chest. And he'll say, Daddy, I'm sorry. Daddy, I love you. Amen, there's some people in here tonight. Amen, that need to lay their head back on Daddy's chest. There's some people in here tonight that needs to come back and say, Daddy, I'm sorry. Amen, because there's a feeling that comes. Amen, before the repentant heart feeling.
Amen.
There's a prideful spirit that wants to rise up. There's a spirit of anger that tries to rise up. And I'm here to tell you, the more that you begin to learn to resist the enemy.
Come on.
All right, is this all right?
Come on.
Is this all right?
Come on.
Amen, I'm sorry, but I feel it in my spirit.
Come on.
Amen, there's a spirit of rebellion that's trying to come over the house of God.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. I don't know if this is a dedicated church building or not. Amen, but I feel inside of me, anything that you set apart, amen, to come together with the brother and sister, ought to be a holy place.
Yeah.
Well, come on now, somebody. It ought not be a place to get together and backbite. Amen. And begin to talk about sister this and brother that. He said to let my house be a house of prayer. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. I loved when the little brother said just a minute ago that he can still come to an altar. Hallelujah. There's so many people today that are scared to come to an altar of repentance. Amen. Or to get before God and pray a little while because they're afraid of the judging eyes that's watching.
Right.
Amen.
Yep.
Hallelujah.
Come on.
Amen. Can y'all promise me this? For the next, I don't know. I like having church a long time. For the next hour, 2 hours, 3 hours. Hey, I'm an hour and a half from home. I might as well just get me a hotel. Amen.
Come on,
somebody. But can you promise me for the next few hours? Hey, man, I want Brother J-Bob, hey, man, to open that door just a little bit for just a moment. Hey, man. Hey, man, hallelujah. Can you stand on your feet if you will, if you're able?
Come on.
Just for a moment. Hey, man. Hey, I believe in doing things in the natural as well as in the spiritual.
Right.
I want you to begin to wipe from your shoulders down your arms. I want you to begin to show the devil that I'm not going to let anything stay upon
me.
I'm wiping off any hindrance right now in the name of Jesus. I keep every judgmental spirit out of this house. I keep every unclean thing out of this house. Everything will be done in decency and in order.
Right.
Amen.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Amen. I don't want to stay in the way. But hallelujah. Who can raise their right hand?
Yeah.
Who can raise their left hand?
Yeah.
Who can shake them?
Yeah.
Who can shake them?
Hallelujah.
Amen. Now I know you ain't got one excuse that you can't believe.
I know you.
I have a feeling that there's some people outside of these walls.
Right.
Sitting in a few of these homes.
Come on.
That need to hear a good shake.
Yeah.
I'm not talking about the one that the King of Rock and Roll began to sing about, but I'm talking about the King of all me. Amen. The one that can shake you loose. Hey man, there's a new song that plays on the radio. Hey man, called He's a Chain Breaker.
Right? Come on.
Who's been battling a few chains here lately? Hey man, I'm not around. Hey man, there's a thing. Can I be honest with you for a moment? Hey man, I'm a man in the flesh. Hey man, and there's a thing that's tried to get a hold of me that's been passed down generation upon generation through my family. Amen. And it's a spirit of anger. Amen. And I battle it every day. Amen. Who's going to be honest over this Black Friday stuff? Amen. You're reaching into that basket to get them towels that were $1.60 at Walmart. Amen. The woman next to you, she's grabbing your pile and you're grabbing her pile, and you're feeling that thing inside of you. I'm here to tell you, that's the devil. Come on now.
Amen. Come on.
Hallelujah.
Come on, preacher.
Hallelujah. We fight over things in the natural.
Right. Come on.
Amen. But we sit back and we let the devil win in the spiritual.
Oh, my God.
Amen. Who's ready to fight for some $1.60 spiritual towels tonight? Come on. Come on. I've seen people. Hallelujah. Thursday night lined up the door, Brother J. Paul. Hallelujah. I heard the sister say, is there anybody that wants to say something for the Lord? Hallelujah. Every single one of you should have jumped up out of your seat and said, I've got something to praise God for.
Come on.
Hallelujah. Amen. Can we be real in the house tonight?
Right. Come on.
Hallelujah. Hey, man, I'm ready to go to war.
Yep.
Hey, man, is there anybody else ready to go to war?
Amen.
Yeah.
Come on.
Hallelujah. Hey, I don't know about you, but ever since that movie came out, I hear 1,000 people. I see it every day on Facebook.
Come on.
Well, I've been in my war room. Hey, man, the world would be turning a different way if that for us was truly in the war room.
Yeah.
Hey, amen. But you know what we can do, whether you truly do or not at home? In this place, in this very hour, we can begin to go to war.
Amen.
Hey, man, you might not be sick in body. Hey, man, you might not need a healing. But I guarantee you that there is more than one of us that knows a few people that needs a touch from the Lord.
Yeah.
Amen. Hey, man, and if there's nothing wrong with you, what's wrong with getting a hold of the throne room for somebody else?
Amen.
Come on.
Well, hey, man, you hold the key to my blessing tonight. Hallelujah. Hey, man, and I'm not going to hold the keys to yours.
Come on.
Hey, man, I'm going to step out of the way. But yeah, while you're standing, you might as well give God a hand. Hallelujah.
There you go. Yeah.
Yeah. Lord God, you broke the walls. Hallelujah, God, if you came for it, hallelujah.
Come on,
yeah.
Sometimes it puts on a marriage. Amen. But not only are we going to pray for his safety, amen, but we're going to pray for this home. Amen. We're going to go ahead and bind every enemy thought. We're going to go ahead and we're going to bind every thought and every attack that the enemy is going to try to send. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
Heavenly Father, Lord God, right now.
Yes,
God, I pray, God, God, that same protection, God, God, that you had over David. Amen. When he went and sought and recovered all. God, I pray, God, that you, Father, put a line upon his feet. God, that you can ordain his steps. God, and return to your rest. But Heavenly Father, Lord God, I pray over his home that God, that it will stand. God, it will not get it out. God, it will fill the comfort in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We bind every attack of the mind from the devil right now in the name of Jesus. Father, I want to pray peace right now and understanding, Father, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. This is not the enemy's playground, but hallelujah, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. God, this woman has stood for you. And God, she has not come standing for you. In the name of Jesus.
Father, I want to pray. God, the word of God and the enemy's tactics, God. And the blood of the pigs, Father God, that they come to people. And they have a hand, God. Lord God, I pray, God, that you would hear her, Father. God, that she would be able to stand, Father. Lord God, and when the enemy tries to come, hallelujah, God, that you would let her know, God, and let her be aware, Father. Lord God, so that she can call it for what it is, God, and she would be able to rebuke the very ones that come against her, Father. Lord God, the very ones that come, God, to try to break the home of God. Lord God, I pray, God, that you would expose them, God. Hallelujah, God, and that you would let her be able to see them, Father God, as they're walking towards the night. Lord God, that you would give her discernment.
Hallelujah.
God, that you would speak to her, Father God, louder than you've ever spoken. Hallelujah, God, that you would guard her heart and mind, Father. Lord God, that you would come to my side and be cold. That as she goes to battle, Father God, I pray, God, that you would stand. Hallelujah, God, that you would shield her, Father.
Hallelujah,
God. Glory to God. Peace of mind in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, God. And Lord God, that when it comes home, Father, that you know that Father will be there, Father. Lord God, that the love, God, that they will belong to our God. Lord God, that you and Father God, that they will be dreams of God. Hallelujah, God, that you would make a Father God.
Hallelujah. Unity, Lord, in the name of Jesus.
Lord God, and that you would help on Father God.
Yes, God. Hallelujah.
The power of doubt, Father God, that you call them to be.
Hallelujah.
Lord God, let them know, God, that they came from hell, Father God, to work for you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.